Jared Obligi for MIA Sports.net. Steve Nichols in front of me, highly successful coach here for the McDonough Eagles, who at one point in time this season were ranked number one in the country. They'll be playing on Monday night at Johns Hopkins at 7 o'clock against the winner of tomorrow's Calvert Hall St. Joe game. Coach, in the 3 years I've been covering you now, you are 61-4. You'll be going for your third consecutive championship. Talk about today's 5-0 win over a scrappy Loyola team.
Oh, yeah. Loyola's a good team. They're very disruptive. They make things difficult on you. And it's hard to play against them. I mean, thank God we're in our field. We have a little bit more space here. But today we did a lot, much better job with our space. You know, we scored 5 goals, but, you know, I think, you know, Timmy made some phenomenal saves. We could have scored a couple more, obviously. But, you know, we're happy with the result. This senior class is unbelievable. I mean, they've been to 4 finals. Their freshman year, they lost to Curly 1-0. They beat Curly their sophomore year 3-0. Beat St. Joe last year 6-1. Now they're going back again for the 4th straight time, trying to win the 3rd in a row, which no MIA team has ever done. As a program, we're going to our 11th final in 12 years. I mean, that's unprecedented as well. We're going to try to win our 6th. It's unbelievable. It's a great program for great kids. The senior class kind of defines what we're all about here at McDonough, from Mamadou to Marquez to Jojo to Banger to Kirkwood to Jake Weiner, a whole lot of them. Rockefeller, they're a good Neil Desai, who couldn't play today because he had the flu. They're a good bunch of kids. And we've played this entire year without a handful of starters every single game. We've never had our starting lineup or even close to our starting lineup.
And you still don't.
And we
right?
still don't. And finally, after that Calvert Hall loss, I think we figured it out. You know, no more excuses. You know, we're 20-2 now. It took those 2 losses to figure out, hey, we're not going to have all these guys the whole year. And since then, we beat John Carroll 6-0, Gilman 4-0, Loyola 3-0, Curly 3-0, Whitman 6-0. Now we beat Loyola 5-0. We've been on a tear ever since then. And we said, hey, no more excuses. We got what we got. Let's play what we got, and let's go after them. And they did it again today. So I got to give them credit. They're a good bunch of kids, and they work hard, and they're very, very, very talented, obviously.
Well, we're looking forward to covering you again Monday night, and I wish you all the best. Anything else you want to say in terms of, I know you did not have full strength all year long.
Sure.
How many guys were out? Who was that?
Kyle DeVinny's played a total of 5 minutes this year. He had a stress fracture. His foot went up to Spalding. He stepped in a hole in Spalding, on their field and broke it again. Lucas, about 10 games into the season, was a leading scorer, and he's closed down for the rest of the year. Had his third concussion.
Hmm.
And then we've missed Marquez for 4 weeks. We've missed Mamadou for a week, Shinsky for 2 weeks, Benga for a week, JoJo for a week and a half. Now we missed Neil this whole week. Desai was our starting center back there. We've been hell and back with this stuff. But like I said, great teams and great players, they persevere. These guys have learned a life lesson doing that. They learn to persevere and get it done. And now hopefully we get one more Monday night and we'll get our 3rd in a row.
All right, Coach. Thanks for coming on. Well done. Well described. Another great win. We'll see you Monday.
Thank you. Thanks, Jeff.